functional neuron or not. And then that goes right back down. No, they go up and then they go down.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, so we're going to reset. Yeah, I don't think they do. So it goes up, but as soon as it opens, it basically closes again. Right, so it's just up and then down. Okay. So imagine it actually happens faster than that. For real. Okay, so now comes the fun part. What if you take a neuron, an axon, and... these proteins don't go away. Okay. What if you take an axon and you were to just poke it right in the middle? Right? So imagine you just poked it, and when you poked it, you opened up one of these channels. So imagine I poke it in the middle. You didn't. Okay. Because it turns out those ions actually spread out on both sides. So, you ready? So if I theoretically poke it in the middle, one side's faster. So if I poke it in the middle, it'll go in both directions. Now it turns out normally I can do that experimentally, and that's actually what would happen. Normally it doesn't happen because normally we start on one end of the axon. That axon hillock, think back to describing the neuron. There's an axon hillock, and that's typically the first place that a neuron generates an action potential. And so typically it's on one end, and that means that this is just always going to flow in one direction. Eventually. Yeah. Thank you. You guys can sit down. You were great.